Flagga, you're finally getting to catch up with a figure I'd missed out there on doing some reviews. Mysterio from the Build-A-Figure Marvel's Lizard Wave, which we've just taken a look at. So all of the figures in the wave have had a review. Check them out. Get some kind of web backing inside the box, little Spidey logo deep down inside there. And there are two versions of this figure, which we'll get to in just a minute. Gorgeous John Tyler Christopher artwork, as usual. Always the man. He does such good artwork. Just insanely talented guy. Spidey logo up at the top. And on the back of the box, we get some very cool Mysterio artwork. A master of illusion, Mysterio seeks universal fame as a cloaked villain with an unmistakable helmet. Yeah, too right, man. It's a goldfish bowl. Anyway, look, this is based off the comic incarnation of Mysterio, of course. We haven't had anything yet in movies. He's a very popular comic character, and this guy is getting scalped to death. The variant figure is a green version of his head. This is the white version. Actually, I prefer the white version. I haven't seen the green. But you may vary. But we'll take a look and show you this figure anyway. Again, all of the parts make up the Build-A-Figure, which has its own separate review. So 7-8 figures in this wave to be reviewed. If you want to pick it up, there's a link in the video below underneath on YouTube, and there's a UPC should you need it. Right, let's get a look at him. So he comes with these kind of effects of magic, I guess, underneath his kind of feet, which can be unplugged and taken off. In terms of height, he's a very tall character there, just over 6 inches tall. Certainly looks very tall. But we get a very plain body, but the detail on these extra attachments and the head, which we'll show you, is pretty goddamn amazing. So these are detachable. And they do help the figure stand a little bit along with the cape. So we'll just have to pose him a little bit there. Let's put him against the wall. So what we get is this incredibly cool translucent-y kind of octopus kind of... Wow, I don't know what it is. It's like a green weird explosion of stuff and tentacles. So very kind of authentic to the comics. I think they've done a very good job in that spiraling effect there with the... Again, let me see if I can get up a little bit closer. You can see all the tentacle suckers. Look at that thing. That's badass. So it looks really good under light, the kind of green glowy effect. So not my favourite figure. A lot of people just be like, you're just a heathen, you don't understand. But yeah, I'm more of a movie character figure. I'm not a huge fan of some of the comic ones. But again, nice effects. Again, they just plug over his feet. And it gives it that kind of illusion that he's just thrown a kind of smoke bomb or green smoke bomb down and Mysterio arrives. So nice the way they've done the plastic. It just reflects really nice off the light. Some are kind of lighter plastic, some are different. And it just adds for the nice effect. So well done Hasbro in sculpting that together. Now let's just cut to the chase and get this gigantic goldfish bowl, because you've got to see this. This has to be one of the best sculpts on a figure I have ever seen. Now, it's kind of hard to see. It's translucent white and it's under a white light. But that is a tentacle coming round his neck, going up through his mouth, the skull, and up through his eyeball. Look at that thing. Man, oh man. And it's all squidgy soft. And kind of as if it's kind of been stuck on there just to add that effect. That's crazy. Such a good job. It's a little bit hard to focus so close. And again, being translucent white is just confusing the camera. But look at that thing. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. And it snakes all the way around his head there. Not really detachable. It's kind of plugged into and glued into the head. But it's a skull. And then these two pieces have been... stuck on the side of it, but geez, what a gruesome, horrible design. It's great. Absolutely love it. So again, the variant of that is a green plastic. Not quite as heavy green as that, but certainly a more translucent-y, lighter green. In fact, even lighter than anything here, but this, it almost, if you put the green behind it, you kind of get what it looks like. That's the version that the other version that looks like. I think it's really just a different production run. It's not truly a variant as such, as far as I can tell, but if it is, let me know. Other than that, I'm afraid the rest of the figure is a bit of a letdown. There's nothing else on the body, but it's keeping in line with the comic kind of detail. Down to the boots, fairly simple, pickles, those things that we never get. And all the detail is really reserved for these kind of strange, Mysterio gauntlets that he has, where all the weathering has been applied. And look at the difference the weathering makes. to that sculpt on the figure. Really, really nice detail going on there, and incredibly luminous green hands. And there's really not a great deal else going on the figure. Now, the cape is nicely done as well. We've got a lot of nice detail on that, on the sculpt. The little trademark kind of little buttons that he has in his cape, and the design of the cape. You can see the little fans on the cape. See a little fan shape everywhere? Very cool, very nice. And the plane is plain on that side too. But nice folds and cuts there that just makes it feel absolutely right. And again, pop that on over the head. Now you'll see there's a little peg hole at the back. It's a little bit hard to get this on, but if you do it right and hold that back and then get that plugged in to the back, it kind of holds the helmet on in the right way. And you can kind of see a little bit of smoke detection through that smoky filter there on the helmet. And his head's a little squint there, so we have to... It's a little bit weird, this, trying to get this sorted. Let me turn it back around that way. Pop it in and turn, if I can. There we go, that's better. And then fiddle around with the back of this. It's a bit of a pain. But it kind of stays in place. But what you get is this, well... If it's truly done like that, you kind of get this floatiness on the side of the cape there. So it kind of works. It kind of works. They've done their best, I think. It's very hard to do with such a huge-ass flowing cape. But he's pretty cool. He's a pretty cool figure and one that a lot of people want. So you're going to be struggle if you don't pre-order this or get it online somewhere. It's still dribbling out in stock from Hasbro, but yeah, it's... not quite distributed everywhere yet, so you may get to see more, but certainly overseas outside the US, I don't think you're getting this wave, people, so get it ordered. In terms of articulation, we've got the ball joint in the head, which spins around pretty reasonably considering there's a big huge ass tentacle coming out of it. No other real restrictions on the figure. Ball joint hinge up at the shoulder. You got a bicep swivel, double joints at the arms. There's no, yeah, those gauntlets don't turn, but you do get swivel wrists and back and forth too, so plenty of movement there. Ab crunch, standard stuff. Swivel, there's no restrictions on them as you can see. Pins, thigh swivel, double joints at the knees. Oh, it is a boot cut. Nice, we get an extra boot cut too, and rocking ankles for those incredibly luminous boots. But a very cool figure. A lot of people will love this. A lot of people are after it, so yes. Grab the whole wave. The whole wave is awesome. And what a great builder figure you get. So what are you waiting for? Grab it. Link in the description below. If you like other 6-inch figures and Black Series stuff, I'm sure you know the drill, but we do a show called The 6-Inch Show. Click the subscribe button, the little bell. It will come straight to you. That's it for me. We'll see you for more Marvel Legends and Black Series reviews coming right up. Cheers.